Good morning, everyone. My name is Kim, and I'm a science researcher. Whenever I tell people that I study cancer, their common response would be, "Have you found a cure?" Well, the concept of a cure sounds very grand. It's not that simple. On the photo is all the pathways dysregulated in cancer. The most popularly studied one is this one, the PI3K pathway. And we know two things about it. First, we know its function, that it controls growth and survival of cancer cells. And second, we know which genes, when mutated, cause this pathway to become permanently switched on. Now, it's pretty clear that an obvious solution is to inhibit this pathway, and that's what scientists have done. More than 40 inhibitor compounds reached clinical trials, and out of these 40, the FDA approved 4. If you think we've made headway, unfortunately, no. Perhaps to create better treatments, we need to look at this picture differently. Perhaps we're missing an element for it to make sense. I suggest we look at junk, a term given long ago to non-coding RNA. These RNA molecules that do not become proteins are in fact functional. And one special type is called the microRNA, named simply because it's very short in length. Now, in my research, I found one microRNA, and I made a very interesting observation. I found that it binds to the RNA transcript of PIK3CA, and it degrades it. What happens? It tunes down the pathway, killing cancer cells. Problem solved. This makes the microRNA the hero in this molecular drama. But just like any other story, there's a plot twist. Within our cells is another gene, ZNF148, which is an accomplice of PIK3CA. Think of it as a decoy that lures the microRNA away from PIK3CA. The effect? PIK3CA still wins, cancer cells survive. Having observed this, we then came up with an idea. Instead of designing drugs that inhibit PIK3CA, why don't we design those that inhibit ZNF148? This could push the microRNA away from PIK3CA, going back to PIK3CA, therefore inhibiting signaling, therefore stopping cancer progression. This is what I'm currently investigating in my lab, and I've never been more excited to find an answer. Imagine the impact this has for finding new drug targets or new disease biomarkers. We're still far from completely eradicating cancer, but when great minds work together, it's not impossible to get there. I'd be happy to take some questions.